Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for coming tonight. My name's John Muellner. I'm the drama director here at Churchill High School. We're happy to put on a great show for you tonight. A couple of thank yous before we get started. Parents, couldn't do it without you. My moms and dads have been absolutely fabulous, amazing people. Thank you from the bottom of my heart and so do the kids. I'd like to thank Sheldon High School. Are they here today? Good show, guys. We really enjoyed it a lot. Looking forward to the next one. Nice system here we got going. I'd like to thank this marvelous band who've put together in a power situation, a perfect situation. Yeah. And led by the inimitable Mr. Chris Mudd. And our corporate sponsors, without their generosity, we would be hard-pressed to put on the show that you will see tonight. So at least sit back, enjoy, and get ready for some nonsense. See ya.
Show tonight? Oh, okay.
Hey.
How are you guys?
Hi.
It's so good to see like people. I didn't see you in church.
Shit.
Next time. Okay. Good luck tonight. Good luck. Good luck.
Okay. All right, guys. Ladies and gentlemen, I do believe it is time to, start this show. So shit. All right. Now Reverend Mother's on her way over here, and I think you guys need to help us put Reverend Mother in a good mood. Because believe me, there's nothing worse than a crabby Reverend Mother. Not a happy thing. Yeah. Okay, so when she comes out here, I want you guys to stand up, and I'm serious, stand up and do the Mount St. Helens cheer. Now, in case you guys don't know what the Mount St. Helens cheer is, it goes like this. Ho, 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 ho! It's not that hard. You guys can even do it. Okay, we're going to have a little practice round on count three, okay? One, two, three. Ho, 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 ho!
Okay, good job. You guys are awesome.
All right.
Naturals.
Remember, you guys got to make it really big because, oh God, if she gets.
And here's the Reverend Mother, Sister Mary Regina.
No! Oh, you shouldn't have. Oh! Oh my goodness, this is too much. Oh dear.
Let's hear for the Mount St. Helens Band.
Now, are we ready to begin? Yes?
Have you seen Sister Amnesia?
What? Father Mudd, have you seen Sister Amnesia?
She looks like
have you seen Sister Amnesia? She's about yay tall. Stop there. 1 minute.
Can I go to the faculty?
Sister Amnesia! Oh, don't look. Don't give me that look, Sister Amnesia. Come on out, they're all friends. Don't look at me that way. Come on. She's a little bit nervous. She's a big mess is what she is. Now, may I have some light, please? Sister, give me the light. Over here, where is the light? Sister, follow my boys. Follow my boy down, sister. Thank you. That's Sister Mary Myopia. Our archery instructor. Now, may I just say welcome to all of you to the Mount St. Helens School, and may I extend my gratitude, our gratitude on you coming here this evening tonight. Now, before we begin the festivities, I want to clear up what seems to be some confusion about the set here. You see, our eighth graders, they're putting on the musical Vaseline, and I thought I would tell you
about. No.
Yes?
Grease.
It's what?
Grease.
Greece?
G-R-E-S-E.
It's Greece.
Greece. Correct.
Oh, well, it's Greece. Anyways, I told our eighth graders that we wouldn't mess around with their little set, so that's why things may seem a little incongruous at times. Now, we have a wonderful introductory number, but before we begin, let us ask the Lord to bless our endeavors. Sister, sister, if you will. Wondering why we're all gathered here. You see, we've had a small disaster back in the convent. You see, Sister Julia, child of God, made some Vichy Sois soup and nearly every sister died instantly of botulism.
It was kind of like the Last Supper. little convent joke.
Why, we'd all be gone if it hadn't been for the fact that we were out playing bingo with some merry moons. What a bunch of cutthroats they turned out to be.
I still say their mother superior cheated when she didn't call me 15. I knew we had it. All right, B15, she called 057, then I had
it. Calm down, sister! The thing is that when we got back to the convent, we found 52 of our dead sisters lying face down in that soup.
Now, we had no idea what to do, so we all began praying for guidance.
Then, I had a vision.
Oh?
It was either St. Catherine of Siena or St. Thomas Aquinas in drag. They look awfully alike, don't you think?
Hard to tell them apart.
Anyways, I was instructed to use our own Sister Mary Cardelia as a model for a greeting card company, and of course I did, and of course it was a huge success.
So I took the money that we made from the greeting card company and buried 48 of the 52 dead sisters. And then Reverend Mother bought a VCR for the convent. Of course, I would have buried all the sisters before we bought the VCR, but then as Mistress of Novices, I'm only number two. And one tries hard not to question Reverend Mother.
And one will try hard in the future. That's right, dear. So we had to put our last four dead sisters in the freezer.
Oh, and Sister Julia. Child of God is having a fit about that.
So that's why we're putting on this little show. We have to raise money to bury the last four dead sisters.
But if they hadn't died, we wouldn't be here and there wouldn't be this little show.
But they did, we did, we have to, and so there you are. Yes. Anyways, about a week ago, I held trials for tonight's show, and I chose the sisters whom I felt were the very best of what's left of us.
Oh, yeah. But before we go any further, I thought you might be interested in some history of the Little Sisters of Hoboken, and that is what our next song is all about.
Will you go get them ready?
Oh, gladly. Oh,
thank you.
Girls!
You see, we started out running a leper colony. Oh, I know that sounds a bit distasteful, but you have to understand, all good causes were taken. You see, it all began when we... Oh, we're all ready. Well, I won't spoil it for you. Let's just do it, going to be quizzed on it afterwards, so pay attention. Filled with great anxiety, Sister Hubert sailed with me and Sister Robert had to a land of unknown circumstances. We reached our destination with a bit of trepidation, for we come to all the lepers back to work in southern France.
No,
that's not right. We come to join an order working with lepers on an island south of France. Oh. That's it.
Each of us as best we could cut a tree and chop some wood, which then was used in building humble huts for quarantine. When Sister Marquibot had finished up the voyage on, we all sat down and waited for the first of those unclean.
And they came from everywhere.
There were Hottentots with Rottentots of baskets on each mother's head. On natives who were being fed,
and Swazi who were good,
oh,
and
okay.
Bushmen in the line of hand.
It was dreadful. The babies had their noses stuck in everybody's business, while Watusis had their business stuck in everybody's nose. But the truth of the matter, if you really want to know, was that everybody's business was about to be controlled.
Hubert, Robert, Dan, and I are lucky that we're still alive. Went to pieces at a devastating rate. When a novice spilled her food at first, we thought it rather crude. Till we realized her hand was on the floor with her fork and her plate.
Wait!
There's more!
The Protestants, it seems, had set out to wreck her dream.
We had humble huts all day, but leper condos by the sea.
Competing for each leper, put our mission work in jeopardy, so we devised a plan to avoid catastrophe.
We challenged them to raise, cause we thought we took their race in the 100-meter dash when we entered Sister Rose.
But if she was victory bound, her spots fell on the ground.
If it hadn't fallen off, she'd have won it by a nose.
Horrors. Hubert, Robert, Tanner, and I are lucky that we're still alive, for since went to pieces in a truly hopeless spot.
So we packed up what was left, feeling totally bereft. We got out while the going was still able to be done.
We came back home to Hoboken, but with spirits so broken, no one really knew if we pulled through. And rather, rather afraid, there would be a new crusade. And we were doing great till Sister Julia made that stew. Fondue! Maria, it's so heavenly to be a mother.
Sister,
sister, making a debut in front of you. It's a difficult transition for the missioner's position. Was up till now the only one we knew is sad but true. So we hope you'll understand if we're not absolutely grand. But we will do our best.
1, 2, 3,
all to see that you're impressed. We hope we'll pass the test. Now the rest.
Yes. Yoo-hoo! Okay, where are you going?
I was going with her!
Aren't you in charge of the quiz?
Oh, yeah, I forgot.
Reverend Mother, I just can't seem to get through to her.
Well, we're hoping when she remembers who she is, she'll remember that she's a Franciscan.
That would be nice.
Yeah.
Now, Sister Amnesia, try to remember what I teach in the novitiate. Gentle, but firm.
Gentle, but firm. Gentle, but firm. Eyes forward, sit up straight, pay attention. Do you know what time it is? I always know what time it is, because back in the convent, we have a huge clock with the 12 apostles pasted on it. And I always know that when the big hand is on the John and the little hand is on the Peter, that's time for the nuns to go down on their knees and pray. And now it's time for that little speech that Reverend Mother warned you about. You should have the answers if you paid attention to the last song. Are you ready?
Yeah.
I said, are you ready?
Yeah!
All right. Well, now if you know the answer, raise your hand. Question number one. The leper colony was established on an island south of?
France.
But you didn't raise your hand. I'll give you one more chance. The leper colony was established on an island south of? Come on, guys, I know you have an answer. You.
France.
Yes, you're right, he's right. It's a St. Christopher Motorist prayer card. It says, I am Catholic. In case of emergency, please call a priest. Are you Catholic?
Actually, yes.
Wow! First one. All right, question number two. This one's a lot harder. Why did the nuns leave the leper colony? I'll give you a hint. Has to do with forks and plates. You! Not quite, but okay. She got it right. I've got a prize for you. You're gonna like it a lot. It's a medallion. Do you know who that is? It's on the other side.
Mother Teresa.
Actually, it's St. Francis. You know what, though? Some people thought that St. Francis was a sissy, but that's not true. Reverend Mother told me he was of a sissy, so some people don't get it. All right. How many Catholics do we have here tonight? Just you? Well, you get another prize. It's a medallion. I hope you like it. Now, I have one last question. Sister Hubert wanted me to ask this one. Do you think it was wrong for Reverend Mother to buy a VCR before all the sisters were buried?
Quiz! Go, go, go! That's enough of the quiz. And now we have, oh yes, Sister Mary Leo doing her interpretation of Morning at the Convent. Sister? Oh.
I wake up all weary when I first hear that age-old query.
Ben Adichite.
Dominus. God, we can't speak to each other. I'm not in the mood to be cheery. Put on the tunic and scapular. Then the wimple. Look, no mirror. The gimp and veil complete the nun's couture. At an ungodly hour, the bell in the tower signals a warning. We've made it through one more night. It's time to greet a new morning. But before I go down,
Leo, you know how Reverend Mother feels about the traditional habit.
I know. If God had wanted everyone to look like people, he wouldn't have invented nuns.
That's right.
But when I enter the convent, I plan to dedicate my life to God through the dance. If I can't wear a tutu, I'll never become a famous nun ballerina.
Sister Leo, have we forgotten about humility?
I've always taught the novices that God is on their side when they're looking for the strength to avoid the sin of pride.
I know that being humble is virtue we hold dear, but how can I be humble and advance in my career?
Sister Leo, your vocation is your career. Would you excuse me for a second?
Now, Sister Leo, there's something I'd like to talk to you about. You see, ever since I was a little girl, it was my dream to enter the convent, work my way up to Mother Superior, and then turn the Little Sisters of Hoboken into the Big Sisters of Newark.
Now, the first lesson I had to learn upon entering the convent was that we do not strive for a position, just profession. Besides, she who exalts herself shall be humbled, and she who humbles herself shall be exalted.
Wow!
Reverend Mother is the boss, and so I must obey. But as mistress of the novices, I shine in my own way.
You mean if I'm really humble, I could have a shot at a bit of exaltation with my simple lot?
You got it, kid. The biggest ain't the best. Very often we're impressed by a tiny diamond ship that seems to outshine all the rest. So pay attention now. Here's what you must do. Don't demand the spotlight, let the spotlight come to you.
I'm beginning to see the light.
Remember Sister Hilda, whose endowment was so great.
When she put on her collar, it stood out like a flame.
Well, one day when the bishop came, she went to the door. She knelt to kiss his ring. She fell flat out on the floor.
And the biggest ain't the best, as the bishop will attest. The Lord tells us the least are often those that are the blessed.
So let that be a lesson to you, try to understand. The people with the biggest drums don't always lead the band.
Oh, the biggest ain't the best. Very often we're impressed by a tiny diamond ship that seems to outshine all the rest.
So do what you do well.
I know I'll be fine.
Just remember to be humble.
Jets, Rev. Everything's okay. Whoa, I got another surprise for you.
Another little surprise?
Yeah. I realized that when you made tonight's program, you hadn't included a solo spot for me.
I intended that.
So I've been working on a little something. Excuse me.
When I became a nun at a very early age.
Sister. Now, you stop the music. Thank you. You are the understudy. You don't know what a great importance that is. Mm-hmm. You have to be ready at a moment's notice should any emergency happen. Okay. Yeah. Now take me, for example. Take me. I'm the Reverend Mother. I'm not some musical comedy star.
Yeah, I realized that one from the opening number.
Listen to me.
I don't mean to sound ungrateful, but I'd rather have a spot that is just for Robert Ann. I'm not asking for a lot. An understudy never shines until the star is ill. Then the crowd is hostile. The star's out on the bill.
Look, I don't think this is something we should discuss
what?
In front of the audience.
Playing second fiddle positively means this kid will never get a moment on the stage alone. Even, God forbid, if something happened and you did get sick.
Yes?
The understudy part is not my own.
Yeah,
now look here, I've been reading up on being an understudy, and believe me, it is not encouraging. Here, read this. Here, who knows that Dolly Levy saw so B.B. Osterwald, Carol Channing wasn't sick, so B.B. wasn't come. This girl, Lenore Nevitz, has it on her resume that she understudied everybody. Where is she today?
Haha, there's Shirley MacLaine.
Oh, no, Shirley doesn't count. That was just bizarre. Carol Haney breaks her leg, and Shirley is a star. But that's about as rare as Anna Turner down at Schwab's. It's a miracle when understudies get the starring jobs.
Well, then you better stop praying, then.
For what?
A miracle.
Oh! Playing second fiddle positively means this kid will never get a lead, because everybody knows whoever understudy Merman as a gypsy mama permanently ended up as second-hand Rose.
I've got to get amnesia ready for her number.
What? My number's all ready to go!
For the last time, no.
So I can prove to Reverend Mother what it takes I got. Maybe then she'll understand this feeling in my soul that I deserve a leading role.
You know, I feel personally responsible for the predicament that's been brought upon us tonight. But you see, Sister Julie has never been able to get a firm handle on her vocation. About a month ago, we were going to have the Monsignor over for supper, so I asked Julia to prepare a little something special. 10 minutes later, I see her setting up the ironing board in the kitchen, and I say to Julia, "Julia, what the hell are you doing?" And so she says to me, "I'm making pressed duck." And so then she says to me, "How do you get down off a duck?" And then I say to her, "Look, how do you get up there in the first place?"
Oh, gosh.
I'm telling you, it's not easy. We used to have 71 members in our order. Now, thanks to that nitwit, we're down to 19. So I figured if you knew a little bit more about us, maybe you want...
I thought I was supposed to do this part.
Oh, that's right. I promised Sister Who's-It's here that she could do this part. Well, go on, Sister, with your little amnesiac ways. God help you. Keep an eye on her, Hubert.
Always our concern. Think about the
didn't somebody tell me she brought that puppet?
Don't look at me! Who knew?
You knew! I know you knew, Hubert.
Well, I knew about the puppet, but I didn't realize that she...
What if there happened to be some plainclothes nuns in the audience?
Please don't let this affect your generosity this evening.
Yes.
Did I miss something?
Just the boat, dear.
Inspectors were coming around.
Yes.
Oh, he came this afternoon.
What do you mean? He came this afternoon. You've been practicing all day here with us.
But he called.
What?
Yesterday.
What? Oh. Amnesia, why didn't you tell me these things? I forgot. Well, go phone the convent right away. This is a terrible... Well, I don't care. Look it up in the phone book, dear. Hubert! I thought I told you to report everything that she did to me.
Now, don't blame this one on me. I'm not the one who bought the VCR.
Don't tell me about the VCR. I didn't know we weren't gonna have enough money.
You could have counted.
You could have told me about the sale. Switch that off. Switch that off this instant.
No.
Now.
Everybody,
Well, dear, what did it say?
Hello. You asked to the convent of Mount St.
Helens. Amnesia. Dear, jump ahead.
Oh, okay. Hello. Here I come.
And Sister Mary G had to go down to the Board of Health for questioning.
Amnesia. Oh, why didn't you? If you had only told me these things, then we wouldn't be in this mess. This is a real mess you caused this time.
You did not have to be so hard on her.
You know, I didn't mean it. Go see if she's all right, please.
I am.
Go
see. If it's all your messes for you.
I'm telling you, it's not easy being a nun. Trying to be a leader in these permissive times is almost, well, impossible. Take Robert Ann, for example. Now, when she entered the convent, they told me she was streetwise. I thought that meant that she knew her way around town. This girl knows things you don't see on cable television. Why, just the other day, she comes waltzing into my office, saying that she's writing a book for her gym class on female hygiene. Do you know what she's going to call it? The Catholic Girl's Guide to Immaculate Conception. I'm telling you, it's not easy. Sometimes I wonder why I became a nun in the first place. I didn't have to. The other sisters don't know this, but I started out to be a tightrope walker. I'm not making this up. My family had a high wire act. They were billed as 2 tons on a tightrope. Our whole family's a bit on the hefty side. All of us kids were in the act, all except for Mary Claire. That was my sister. She took up with a contortionist, and one night they were trying out this new... Oh, that's a bad memory. I don't want to talk about that. Oh, I was telling you about something else. Yes, I was telling you about our act. Well, we got booked in London, and we were going to do a publicity stunt. So we had the wire stretched out across the river. No net, mind you, no net underneath. Well, 2 tons on a tight rope. We're up there. And then... the wire snapped. And boom, boom, 2 tons in the Thames. Right then and there, I promised the Lord that if he had saved him, I would become a nun. And who would have thought that he would have pulled through? And now that I'm here, I wouldn't have it any other way. Still, I've got to tell you. I see the spotlight, and though it's not right, I simply can't resist its call. For some nuns, it's bingo at that parish hall. Turn up the spotlight and I have a ball. I lose my head then, I know I'm dead when I start to hear that laughter grow. Please forgive me, but don't you know, this is much more fun than B-I-N-G-O. Oh!
turn up that spotlight, 'cause when I've got light, I'm a barrel full of fun. I'm your right reverend mother, say hello, darling lover. Oy vey. I'm your right reverend mother, there isn't any other. Your right reverend mother, superior nun. Oh yeah.
Tucker.
Was she a mother superior too?
Not quite, dear. No.
Never saw a thing.
Okay.
Okay.
Lilac.
What?
Lilac.
Oh, whatever.
Oh, lilacs.
Oh, they're beautiful. Who are they from?
Oh, they're from.
Oh, they're from the ladies' altar group wishing us good luck.
Wasn't that sweet of them?
They sure bring back memories.
Every time I smell lilacs, I remember that very special day when the bishop came and gave me my new name. Hubert, I thought I was gonna die.
Maybe the fragrance can take you backwards in time to a place you know.
Hamilton? Listen, Missy. Slow down.
Oh, hold on.
Yes?
I was in the girls' locker room and I found this.
What is it?
I think one of our students has a serious problem.
What kind of serious? Oh, girls, serious problem.
I know about these things and I need to explain it to you.
Can you explain it to me now?
Well, you can tell
girl.
Me after the first act finale.
Hubert,
get them ready for the first act finale.
Oh.
Sure.
No. I need to.
Let's go read a book.
Sorry, but get that thing out of your bag. No, get it out.
No.
I'm melting.
If only she could. Don't give me that. Now, what was this thing she was ranting about? Well, it's called Rush. Must be something for people in a hurry. Yes. I bet you take a spoonful after every meal. No? It says right here. After removing cap, allow to stand, aroma will develop. Aroma? What kind of aroma? Well, she removed the cap, allowed it to stand. Oh! Good Lord! That smells awful! Why would anybody want this stuff? Are you H? It's hot in here. I think it must be this white thingamajig around my head. This stuff can't be good for you. I don't know what the girls are doing, but it smells just awful. That is, if I can remember how it smells. Just looking. Oh! That's right. It smells just terrible. All right. And if you Muellner shortly, we'll get back to nun dance. No flash nun. Woo! Butch Cassidy and that Sundance nun. Father Mudd, what show is this?
Are you all right?
All right, I've never felt better in my life thanks to this stuff. Hey, have any of you tried this stuff? Oh, of course you have, your musicians. Your musicians. Now give me that. Oh, look there. Hold on. Oh, flying off into the wild blue yonder. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, hell with it. Whoops. Oh, Hubert, come out here. I think my leg has been cut off. Everything's falling apart around here. Falling apart. Okay. Let's all just sit back right now and watch a couple of butch nuns dance. Did I just say that? No, no, no. That's... Come on in, the door's wide open. Round and round the merry-go-round.
Give me 1 second. I've got to drive Miss Daisy down to the Piggly Wiggly. You better be moving on up, and moving on into the inside.
Whoa! It's a miracle. Somebody call the donkey and get me to the manger. All right, give me 1 second. I just got to clean myself up. None of you be looking now. None of you, I just got to keep it. Hold on, I can do it. It's just like the little red hand and just lift myself. I think I'm, lift myself up like so. Oh, now I feel like Shelley Winters in the Poseidon Adventure. Everybody, into that pool! Free Willy, beach the whale! You know, it's
our mother!
Hubert, help me, I've fallen and I can't get up.
Turn off that spotlight.
Wait, I'm not quite.
Oh, yes, you are.
She's stuck! Could you die?
Put on some shoes, come on all of you. There's been a slight change in what's about to ensue. But I thought we planned this song for act two. Well, we did, but it's not. We gotta do it now.
If ever you are tempted to transgress, remember this.
Oh, Hubert, you look absolutely marvelous.
An idle mind is where the devil works. So in my analysis, if busy hands are happy hands, then dancing feet are bliss. So, back of anticipation with the time. Step, not a 1 step or a 2 step, but a time. Yeah, stomp, 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 stomp in your tap shoes. You can chase the devil out, shout the good news, so back of anticipation with temptation with the time step, not a 1 step or a 2 step but a time step.
holy water.
I don't know. How do you make holy water?
You boil the hell out of it!
Do you remember it?
I think so. Why don't nuns do drugs?
I don't know. Why don't nuns do drugs?
My turn to share with you a little bit of my habit humor. Now, nuns, we don't have a lot of spare time, but when we do have spare time, I like to create other nuns. For instance, guys, still with me? Okay. Sister Pocahontas. How? Sister Pippi Longstocking.
Attila the Nun!
Sister Heidi? Yeah?
Well, I thought that one was funny. Thank you for proving me wrong. Okay, this next one, it's one of my favorites. And you know, they wanted me to be in the new movie, but no. Reverend Mother said no. She's just jealous because they wanted her to be Chewbacca. Okay, ready? Help me, Obi-Wan. Help me, Obi-Wan. Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi. You're my only hope. Now this next one takes a little bit of time, so hey, can I get some moon music, por favor? Thanks. Now, please, tell me if you see anyone coming, okay? Yeah. You know, I do these for my students often. They love to laugh, and hey, that's why they listen to me. You know, I teach a 7th grade. That's a rough age to be. Believe me, when I was in 7th grade, I got sent to the St. Clair School for the Deplorable. With a name like that, you can't go wrong. All right. Yeah, who knew you could do one of these things, huh? All right, you know, guys, I do think we are ready for the final impression of the evening.
The calla lilies are in bloom again. Such a strange flower.
You guys are too kind, really, okay. Oh, man, let's not mention this to you-know-who. Reverend Mother doesn't always agree with my methods or my behavior. But you know, you gotta understand, I grew up in Canarsie. You know where that is? Brooklyn. Yo, mama, Skunjili. Now, my father, hold on. Gotta get the stool. My father was never around much, and well, my mother, she was gone a lot, so us kids were home alone a lot. And I was in trouble. Always in trouble. But hey, that's why I got sent to the St. Clair School for the Deplorable. But things worked out. My background even paid off a little bit. Not only do I drive the convent car, but I can strip it faster than any mechanic in Hoboken, and don't think I can. You know, some of my friends still can't believe I'm a nun, but I gotta tell you why. It's all because of Sister Rose Frances. Sister Rose Frances was the head of St. Clair's. Boy, oh boy, was she something special. She was the one person that made me believe that I was worth something, and I want to be just like her. But that was a long time ago. Things have changed. I feel a song coming on.
At St. Clair School, religion class began with Mass each day. It was said in Latin then, that's how I learned to pray. Appeared in black and white, and so did every rule. Things were either wrong or right at St. Clair's Catholic School.
Hosanna, Hosanna, in excelsis, excelsis,
in excelsis.
But then the rules began to change and many lost their way. What was always black and white was turning shades of gray. It's everywhere. The church is quite progressive now, so people ridicule the fact that so many things are optional. It's hard to find a rule. Through it all, I've often said those ancient Latin prayers.
Well, take a look.
Oh, my. We've got to clean up the freezer
by tomorrow morning.
Because the Jersey Board of Health has sent the final warning.
They're not buying our lime at Denham's. Rise and shine, we must defy or face a fine. We've got to clean up the freezer because they know we're the ones who have refused to start defrosting those four blue nuns. The time has come. Send them off to their reward and let them greet the Lord. Heaven awaits, so pack them in crates and tell St. Peter they'll be at those pearly gates and tell them these are.
for me. Oh, is she coming over to do the show?
Is she coming over to the show? No.
No?
No.
Whoa.
Oh, I could do my number.
I don't think so. Hmm. No, we have to find Julia's book. Does anybody know what happened to Julia's book?
I forgot it. But I left it in the station wagon.
Well, will one of you go get it for me?
I'll get it for you.
Well, all three of you go.
Okay.
You know what I like best about this show?
What?
We haven't had to stoop to a single penguin joke.
Oh, Hubert, we've got sisters in the freezer, Mary Jean down at the Board of Health, and I don't know Julia's pot. What's a Reverend Mother to do? Many people think that in a convent, a Reverend Mother is something like a queen. Nothing could be further from the truth here. Shall we show them what I mean?
Whatever you say, Your Highness.
Hit it!
We're just a couple of sisters, plain as we can be. Just a couple of sisters who discovered harmony.
Oh, sure, I could go solo.
Going solo can be fun,
but when two solos get together, they harmonize as one. We're just a couple of sisters out here having fun.
The mistress of the houses and Reverend Number One.
Oh, it's true, I am in charge, but I know I'm not alone. As long as Sister Hubert adds her harmonizing tone.
I train all our novices and do it on my own. 'Cause I know Reverend Mother's near a stepping stone.
A stepping stone? A stepping stone to what, Hubert?
Regina, it was just a rhyme. You see, the only other word that I could think of was overgrown, and I know how you get about your weight.
I'll have you know very well, Hubert, I am not fat. I'm simply retaining water.
I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen, Lake Superior.
Put us both together, and we've got it all. The melody,
the harmony,
St. Peter and St. Paul.
All we need is Mary, then we'd have a singing group.
Every Tom and Dick and Harry is a Mary in this group. Sister Mary Thomas.
Sister Mary Richard.
Sister Mary Harold.
Sister Mary Knoll.
Sister Mary Martin.
Sister Mary Pickford.
Sister Mary Sunshine. Hey, we're on a roll. Sister Mary Hartman.
Sister Mary Hatter.
Sister Mary Widow.
Sister Nelson Rapp.
Sister Nelson Puffin. Sister Mary Christmas.
Sister Nelson Mary Rapp.
Just a couple of sisters in what you call reform, who've come to entertain you by singing up a storm. Swannies, how I love you.
I love Reverend Mammy.
We're just a couple of sisters, plain as we can be. Just a couple of sisters who discovered
Robert, one more little act like this, and you'll be the dying nun. Get this out of your veil. Get her out of that.
It was just a joke.
Well, it wasn't funny. Who do you think you are, Sally Field?
Yes, and they like me. They really, really like me.
Oh. Stop that. She'll see you.
Well, it was funny.
No, no, it wasn't. It's not enough I've got to contend with Robert Town here.
Oh, she's not that bad. At least she's not in jail.
Well, got more important things to discuss. And that I'm talking about the publication of this book. Baking with the BVM.
Reverend Mother, perhaps we should explain to some of our non-Catholic friends in the audience.
Non-Catholic, out.
Yes, non-Catholic. There. That the BVM is actually the Blessed Virgin Mary.
Thank you, Hubert.
You're welcome.
Baking with the Blessed Virgin Mary. Happy?
Lovely.
Yes.
Ooh.
What's
Reverend Mother!
Yes?
You look like the Pope!
Oh, really?
Regina, do your Pope imitation.
No, I shouldn't.
You want to see it? Come on.
No,
you
I don't.
You want to see it, don't you? Come on, let's do it.
Okay.
She can do it in Italian, too.
Yes. Well, oh, we can see. Oh, hold on, Hubert. We can see that the front cover. Oh, well, let's just show them now. It's our own mother in her cook's hat and apron with her ladle. Here, closer.
$29.95.
Yes. Oh, that's Sister Amnesia has made a wonderful holder for it. Wait, you see this? Oh, it's lovely. Isn't that cute?
Lovely.
Cute.
Yeah.
Did you make that? She made that.
Yeah.
All by yourself. All by yourself, dear? All by herself.
Oh, yeah.
Nice house.
Nobody home.
Look, Amnesia, it's an angel. Oh, well, look, all clean. Yes.
Math.
Oh,
Amnesia?
Well, we see the table of contents is just chock full of unusual recipes, like Caesar Frank's Panis Angelicus.
Ooh.
A delightful tasty treat consisting of hot dogs wrapped around anchovies and served on a slice of angel food cake.
Nom, nom.
Oh, lovely.
Has anyone ever tried this stuff?
Well, no, we thought you went over the book with Julia this morning.
I wasn't supposed to go over the book with Julia.
Yes, you were.
No, you said if you were going to sell it.
You said that you would get over the book with Julia.
No, you said if you were going to sell it to these lovely people.
No,
well,
no, no,
it, well, it doesn't matter now, does it?
In a word, yes.
Moving right along. Oh, look. Mortally sinful devil's food cake.
If you eat that, you'll go to hell.
Sister.
Oh, look at this. Mary Magdalene tarts. I bet they're easy.
And cheap. Moving right along.
Look, a recipe for Boy Scout treats.
Why don't you read that one, dear?
Okay.
Amnesia.
Huh?
Out loud, sister.
Oh, okay. Boy Scout treats. First, get 12 brownies real hot.
That's a misprint. You never heard a thing. Isha. Oh, look at this one. Historic recipes. Barbecued ribs, St. Joe.
That Julia, she's a real killer.
Amnesia? I need a page.
Oh.
Look at that one.
Yes. Turkey stuffing a la Martha Stewart.
It's a good thing.
Well, it must be. Well, right here it says, you take one package of regular stuffing mix.
One package of regular stuffing mix.
One onion mince.
One onion mince.
One cup of unpop popcorn.
One cup of unpop popcorn.
You mix it all together. You stuff it in your bird.
Stuff it in your bird.
You put the bird in the oven.
The bird in the oven.
You heat it up to 400 degrees.
400 degrees.
And when his butt blows off, he's done.
And when his butt blows off. Didn't say that.
It's a misprint.
Holy smoke.
No,
she's approved, but she's included the recipe for that soup.
Is it poisonous?
Well, how should I know?
You could have gone over the book with Julia.
You could have gone. Well, we can't use this thing, and now.
Well, what are we going to do? We were counting on this book to bring the extra money to pay the last four dead sisters.
Any suggestions?
I could do my tongue percussions, and I could do my fire guitar.
No, none of that.
I could do my number.
Well, sing it, Louise.
You mean it?
Yes. Get over there before I change my mind. I feel like I'm back in the leper colony the way things are falling apart around this joint.
How could Julie be so stupid?
How could I be so stupid?
Let me count the ways.
You can count?
Attention. All right. Oh, my cane, please.
Sorry!
Num num. All right. When I became a nun at a very early age, I had to choose between the convent and the life upon the stage. So when Reverend Mother said we're putting on a show, I must tell you I was thrilled to death. I couldn't wait to go. But now to my surprise, Reverend Mother didn't see what's so obvious. The stage is meant for me. Money and fame I don't desire. I only want to sparkle. I'm not here to start a fire. You see, I don't care if I'm ever rich or famous. I just want to be a star. I don't care if you know what my name is. I just want to be a star. I want to be the nun who makes you cheer. The nun who's out in front instead of in the rear. For once I want to lead the band and have the crowd in the palm of my hand. I don't care if I'm ever rich or famous. Just so I can be a star. They didn't know a chorus line from a chorus queen. They didn't realize that in a chorus line, you never get to stretch yourself, you never really shine. I don't care if I'm ever rich or famous, I just want to be a star. Sure, it's true that my only claim to fame is I got what it takes to be a star. I know my vow of poverty says I can make a fortune. And they ask who we are. I just want to say, hey, I was a star. I don't care if I'm ever rich or famous. I just want to be the chorus line. I never had to be a star. Hey, Regina, park your own damn car. I just want to be.
I knew you were trouble from the moment I laid eyes on you. Well, our little sparkler turned out to be quite a firecracker now, didn't she?
I'm sorry, Reverend Mother.
Robert Ann, you were ecstatic.
I was?
Yes. That'll be 6 Our Fathers and 700 Hail Marys. Mm-hmm. And now, presenting Patty, Maxine, and Laverne. Sorry. And a number they prepared especially for this evening. Hey, Robert, quit flirting with that person. Hey, I'm watching. Don't think I'm not. I've got my eye on you.
It seems like only yesterday when life was quite serene. The days are rather uneventful, what you call routine. Then came that fatal night when Julia made her Vichy soise. For 52 Bon Appetit was also Bon Voyage. Then our tranquil life was over, for we knew what we must do. We had to raise the money to ensure the 52. At times it all seemed hopeless and much more than we could bear. We would all have lost our minds if we not stopped.
To go to the drive-in, for skyline driving,
we can always survive it.
We survive.
tell them one of your stories.
They don't want to hear one of my stories.
Oh, well, sure they do, don't you? Come on, you want to hear one of the stories? Yeah, I know you do. Come on. All right.
You really think so?
Yeah, listen.
Do you remember the one I was telling you last week?
Oh, yeah, that's a good one. Why don't you tell them that one? Do you remember it?
Remember what?
The story.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Okay, great.
I'm gonna tell you a little story. It's about me.
Hearing about Sister Mary Paul when we were back in France. But when we got back here, no one knew what happened to her. Then you mysteriously came about, but all you could tell us was that a crucifix fell on your head. So you're Sister Mary Paul! I guess that ends the hope that she's a Franciscan.
Hey, do you remember everything?
Well, I think so. See, there was this contest, and I had a chance to go to Nashville. But then I felt I had this calling. So I decided to become a nun. I'm sure it's the same way all of you felt.
Oh my goodness!
What?
Sister Mary Paul is the nun who won the publisher's clearinghouse sweepstakes! Oh, and there is a reminder! That's you! Saints be praised, we are rich!
Gloria in excelsis Deo!
Let me call in this man.
This means we can bury the last 4 sisters
and get the 36-inch screen for the VCR!
Yes!
And I help!
Oh, know I was really stuck. Did you get worried that we'd have to bury this last one at Sister's tomorrow morning?
Yeah, Jersey smells bad enough as it is.
Robert!
It just goes to show you that the Lord does indeed work in mysterious ways.
One minute we're desperate,
the next minute we're rich! You just never know what the Almighty has planned.
Today, mistress of novices.
Tomorrow the world could be saluting the first Nun Ballerina!
Don't quit your day job, dear. The important thing is that we can send our last ordered sisters to claim their heavenly rewards. And we can get back to claiming our heavenly rewards. Because after all, each and every one here tonight has the potential to become saint.
And you know something?
What?
It's not that hard to be a saint. All you've got to do is pick a saint to emulate who most embodies you. Then figure out what made that saint an idol of today. Yeah. Follow in his footsteps and you'll learn the right to say. I'm holy as now. I've got the spirit now.
Right.
I feel like I'm in heaven because I'm holier than now.
Uh-huh.
I'm holy as now. I've got the spirit now.
Amen.
I thank God Almighty that I'm holier.
Culture.